Hello everybody, myself Prashant Mukhopadhyay, faculty member Electrical Engineering Department, Greater Kolkata College of Engineering and Management. In my last class, so we have discussed about brushless DC machines, that is BLDC motor, its types, working, advantages, disadvantages, applications. And in addition to that, I have also covered the hysteresis motor, its types, construction, working, and applications. Today, we'll discuss a new electromechanical device, that is stepper motor. So, in today's lecture, we'll cover the basics of stepper motors, and you will learn about the working principles, construction, control methods, uses of and types of stepper motors, as well as its advantages and disadvantages. So let us start. Stepper motor basics. Actually, stepper motor is an electric motor which whose main feature is that its shaft rotates by performing steps. Okay, and that is by moving by a fixed amount of degrees. So once again, I am repeating. It's a electric motor whose main feature is that its shaft rotates by performing steps, that means by moving by a fixed amount of degrees. So this feature is obtained thanks to the internal structure of this motor and allows to know the exact angular position of the shaft by simply counting how many steps have been performed with no need for a sensor. So this feature also makes it fit for a wide range of applications. So that with this basics, we'll talk about the stepper motor working principles. So as all with electric motors, stepper motors have a stationary part, that is stator, and a moving part, that is the rotor. On the stator, there are teeth on which coils are wired. And while the rotor is either a permanent magnet or a variable reluctance iron core is there. Okay. Now we'll dive deeper into the different rotor structures later. So let's this figure one shows drawing representing the sections of the motor while the rotor is a variable reluctance iron core. So this is the cross section of a stepper motor. This is the rotor, and this is the stator portion, and this is the stator winding. Okay, these are the stator windings. Okay, so these are the windings, and these are the this is stator. So this is rotor. The basic working principle of the stepper motor is like this: by energizing one or more of the stator phases, a magnetic field is generated by the current flowing in the coil, and the rotor aligns with the this field. Okay, so by supplying different phases in sequence, the rotor can be rotated by a specific amount to reach the desired final position. And in this figure 2, so you will get the stepper motor steps. So that is repetition of the working principle, and at the beginning coil A is energized and the rotor aligned with the magnetic field it produces. This is coil A is energized, okay, and magnetic field is produced and rotor is aligned with this. Okay, so actually when coil B is energized, the rotor rotates clockwise by 60 degrees to align with the new magnetic field. So it is coil B is energized, so as a result rotor energized rotate and aligned with a new position, that is 60 degree with the new magnetic field. The same happens when the coil C is energized. This is coil C is energized, and in the pictures what we are finding, the colors of the stator state indicates the direction of the magnetic field generated by the stator winding. So this is from this, and this, and this. So this is the direction. Okay, so this is the direction that is shown here by this color. And stepper motor types and construction, if we talk about the performance of a stepper motor, both in terms of resolution or step size, that is the step size, speed and torque is influenced by construction details, which at the same time may also affect how the motor can be controlled. And as a matter of fact, not all stepper motors have the same internal structure or construction, as there are different rotor and stator configurations. So this is a very important portion to be remember, that is, it should be keep in mind that not all the stepper motors are of the same structure, internal structure or construction. So both this basically this performance of stepper motor is basically depend on its resolution or step size, speed and torque, and is influenced by construction details, and also at the same time affect the how motor can be controlled. So rotor of a first one to talk about the rotors, say this rotor for a stepper motor, there are basically three types of rotor. One is power magnet rotor, next one is variable reluctance rotor, and then actually what we are finding here, hybrid rotor, and these are the three types of rotor. So these three types of rotors, among these three types of permanent magnet rotor, the rotor is a permanent magnet that aligns with the magnetic field generated by the stator circuit. And this solution guarantees a good torque and also detent torque. And this means the motor will resist, even if not very strongly, to a change of position regardless of whether the coil is energized. The drawbacks of this solution is that it has a lower speed and a lower resolution compared to the other types. So this is shown here, so in this figure 3, so the dimensions of the section of the permanent magnet stepper motor, this is the permanent magnet stepper motor. So this is the rotor and this is a stator, these are the stator winding. So this is actually the representation of a section of a permanent magnet stepper motor, and this is permanent magnet stepper motor. Now variable reluctance rotor, and this rotor is made of an iron core and has a specific shape, and that allows it to align with the magnetic field. So that is shown in this figure 1 and figure 2. See. Actually, see, this is figure 1 and this is figure 2. Okay, so variable reluctance rotor, and with this solution, it is easier to reach a higher speed and resolution, and but the torque it develops is often lower and it has no detent torque, whereas in the power magnet, it has. Didn't talk there. And hybrid rotor, so this kind of rotor has a specific construction. It is a hybrid between power magnet and variable reluctance versions. So this is actually hybrid. So name itself suggests that it is has a specific construction. It is hybrid between this power magnet and variable reluctance versions. So the rotor has two caps with alternating tread and is magnetized axially, and this configuration allows the motor to have the advantages of both the permanent magnet and variable reluctance versions, and specifically high resolution, speed and torque. And this high performance requires a more complex construction and therefore higher cost. And this figure 3 is a simplified example of the structure of this motor also. This is in the figure 3 also is a simplified example of the structure. And when coil A is energized, suppose this coil A is energized, say actually a tooth of the in and magnetized cap aligns with the S magnetized tooth of the stator. This is the case. So actually at the same time, due to rotor structure, the H magnetized tooth aligns with the N magnetized tooth of the stator, and real motors have a more complex structure with a higher number of teeth than one shown in this picture. So though the working principle of the stepper motor is the same, the high number of teeth allows the motor to achieve a small step size, that is down to 0.9 degree. Okay. So this is hybrid stepper motor. Actually, this is hybrid stepper motor. Rotor internal view. This is actually this is stator. Okay. Now about stator. The stator is the part of the motor responsible for activating the magnetic field with which the rotor is going to align. And the main characteristics of stator circuit include its number of phases and pole pairs as well as wire configuration. The number of phases is the number of independent coils, while the number of pole pairs indicates how many pairs of the teeth are occupied by each phase. So two phase stepper motors are most commonly used, and while three phase and five phase motors are less common. So that is shown is this is two phase stator winding, okay, and this is three phase stator winding. Okay, so this is two phase winding, and this is one, say two and three phase winding. Okay, so basically this actually like this. Okay, like this. Okay. So basic this is actually a two phase single pole pair stator. This is two phase single pole pair, and this is two phase double pole pair stator. Two phase double pole pair stator. The latter shows these magnetic field generated when a positive voltage is applied between A plus and A minus. Okay, so this is actually the construction. One again, I am telling you this construction part. I am repeating. Basically, see stepper motor type and construction. It like all other motors. It has say rotor and stator. And rotor are of three types: permanent magnet rotor, and then variable reluctance rotor. This is permanent magnet stepper motor rotors. This is variable reluctance type rotor, and third is hybrid type. Okay, so variable reluctance is figure 1 and 2 is the dash type, and this is a hybrid rotor. This is the first section, and this is stator. Okay, the stator is the part of this motor and creating the magnetic field with which the rotor is going to align. And the main characteristics of the stator circuit include the number of phases and pole pairs, as well as the wire configuration. And the number of phases is the number of independent coils, while the number of pole pairs indicates how many pairs of teeth are occupied by each phase. So two phase stepper motors are the most commonly used, so while three phase and five phase motors are less common. So figure this is actually two phase and this is the three phase stator winding, and this is actually two phase single pole pair stator, and this is two phase double pole pair stator, say double pole pair. Okay, this is single pole. So actually the latest this shows the magnetic field generated while when positive voltage is applied between A plus and A minus. So this is actually the construction part of, so whatever so far we have discussed, that is what is stepper motor, its basics, its types, its construction, and how it works. Okay, so I think if I have a quick repetition of so far discussion, that is stepper motor basics, why it is called stepper motor, how it is worked, then it is all its working principles. So what are the types of its stator, its rotor, and its rotor construction, stator construction, etc. We have discussed so far. Okay. Now we'll discuss stepper motor control. Actually, we have seen that motor coils need to be energized in a specific sequence to generate the magnetic field with which the rotor is going to align. And several devices are used to supply the necessary voltage to the coils and thus allow the motor to function properly. So starting from the devices that are closer to motor, we have a transistor base. Transistor base is the device physically controlling the electrical connection of the motor coils. Transistors can be seen as electrically controlled interrupters, which when closed allow the connections of a coil to the electrical supply and thus the flow of current in the coil. And one transistor base is needed for each motor base. Pre-driver is a device that controls the activations of the transistors, providing the required voltage and current, and it is in turn controlled by an MCU. And MCU is a microcontroller unit which is usually programmed by the motor user and generates specific signals to be for the pre-driver to obtain the desired motor behavior. Okay. So actually so these are the motor behavior. Basically what we have said, so basically a transistor base is a device, a pre-driver is another device that controls the activation of the transistor, and an MCU, a motor control unit, is usually programmed by the motor user and generate specific signals for the pre-driver. So this is actually a transistor base, a pre-driver, and an MCU are the motor control device. So this is shown in figure 7, a simple representation of a stepper motor control schemes, and the pre-driver and the transistor base may be contained in a single device called a driver. So this is driver. Okay. So this is P-driver and control device, transistor base, and this is MCU. So this is going to the motor coil. Okay, so this is motor control basic scheme. So stepper motor driver types, there are several types. There are different stepper motor drivers available in the market. Which showcase different features for specific application, and the most important characteristics include the input interface. The most common options are step or directions by sending a pulse, step or direction by sending a pulse on the step pin. The driver changes the output such that the motor will perform a step, and the direction of which is determined by the label on the direction pin. Okay, this is actually step, and then phase enable. For each stator winding phase, phase determines the current direction and triggers enable if the phase is energized. Then PWM directly controls the gate signals of the low side and high side FETs. So another important feature of a stepper motor is driver is if it is only able to control the voltage across the winding or else or also the current flowing through it. So with the voltage control, the driver only regulates the voltage across the windings and the torque developed and the speed with which the steps are executed only depend on the motor and load characteristics. And current control drivers are more advanced as they regulate the current flowing through the active coil in order to have better control over the torque produced and thus the dynamic behavior of the whole system. Now, unipolar and bipolar motors, another features of the motor that also affects the control is the arrangement of the stator coils that determines how the current direction is changed. And to achieve the motion of the rotor, it is necessary not only to energize the coils but also to control the direction of the current, which determines the directions of the magnetic field generated by the coil itself. So that is shown in the figure 8 actually. In stepper motors, the issue of controlling the current directions is solved with two different approaches. So basically this is the directions of the magnetic field based on the directions of the coil current. Okay. Actually, this is the system. If it is the current direction in this way, so this is north and this is south, and if it is a current direction is in this way, this is this will be north and this is south. So in unipolar stepper motors, one of the leads is connected to the central point of the coil that is shown here. This is unipolar motor drive that is connected to the one central point of this the coil. Okay, so this actually allow the to control the direction of the current using alternatively simple circuit and components. The central lead M is connected to the input voltage V input. That is, say, if MOSFET is MOSFET one is active, the current flows from M to A plus. See, if this is active, so current flow from say here, okay, and M to A plus. And if MOSFET is active, MOSFET 2, current flows from M to A minus. Okay, see this, and this is this. Okay. Generating and as a result, generating a magnetic field in the opposite direction, and as pointed out here in the above. So that is actually here. We have seen that as this approach allows a simpler driving circuit. Only two semiconductors are needed, but the drawback is that only half of the copper used in the motor at a time. This means that for the same current flowing in the coil, the magnetic field has half the intensity compared if all the copper were used. So in addition, these motors are more difficult to construct since more leads have to be available as motor inputs. Okay. So these are the leads available as motor inputs. So this is unipolar stepper motor driving circuit. Clear. So in bipolar stepper motors, each coil has only two leads available, and to control the direction, it is necessary to use an AHB that is shown here. Okay. So bipolar stepper motor driving circuit. So AHB actually is used. So this is actually unipolar. Okay, so in bipolar, each coil only two leads available, and to control the direction, it is necessary to use an AHB. So, and as shown in figure 8, if MOSFETs 1 and 4 are active, MOSFET. So actually, if in bipolar, see, this is actually if it is MOSFET 1 and 4 are active, the current flows from A positive to A negative. These two are active, so current flows from A positive to A negative. Okay, like this. Clear? So. While if MOSFET 2 and 3 are active, the current flows from A negative to A plus positive. If these two are A negative to A positive, if 2 and 3 are active, so like this. So A negative to A positive current are flowing, and generating a magnetic field in the opposite direction. And this solution requires a more complex driving circuit, but allows the motor to achieve the maximum torque for the amount of the copper that is used. Okay, so with technology progress, the advantages of unipolar are becoming less relevant, and bipolar steppers are currently the most popular. So stepper motor, actually these are the stepper motor basic unipolar and bipolar motors actually, and stepper motor driver types. So now we'll discuss about this actually stepper motor driving techniques. Four different driving techniques for stepper motors are available. In a wave mode, only one phase at a time is energized. It is shown here in this wave mode steps. And for simplicity, we will say that the current is flowing in a opposite direction if it is going from a positive lead to the negative lead of a phase, that is from A plus to, as for example, A plus to A minus. Otherwise, the direction is negative. And starting from the left, the current is flowing only in phase A in the positive direction, and the rotor represented by a magnet or is aligned with the magnetic field generated by it. In the next step, it flows only in phase B in the positive direction, and the rotor spins 90 degree clockwise to align with the magnetic field generated by the phase B. And later, phase A is energized again, but the current flows in the negative direction, and but the rotor spins again by 90 degree. In the last step, the current flows negatively in the phase B, and the rotor spins again by 90 degree. So that is shown here. Okay. Basically, this is the wave mode of steps. And another is in full mode, two phases are always energized at the same time. So this is shown here, full mode steps. So see, in wave mode, the rotor rotation directions clear. Now in full mode, two phases are always energized at the same time, and figure 12 shows the different steps of this driving mode. And the steps are similar to the wave mode ones, and the most significant difference being that the with this mode, the motor is able to produce a higher torque since more current is flowing in the motor, and a stronger magnetic field is generated. Okay, and another is the half step mode, is a combination of wave and full step modes. So using this combination allows for the step size to be reduced by half in the case of 45 degree instead of 90 degree. And the only drawback is that the torque produced by the motor is not constant, and since it is higher when both phases are energized, and weaker when only one phase is energized. Okay, so that is half phase mode. Okay, so at different it is shown. So microstepping can be seen as a further enhancement of a half step mode, because it allows to reduce even further the step size and to have a constant torque output. And this is achieved by controlling the intensity of the current flowing in each phase. Using this mode requires a more complex motor driver compared to the previous solutions. And this figure 14 actually shown the micro stepping. Okay. So actually, it's a little bit complicated one. I'm sure that I will not be able to complete this in today's lecture, and I have to repeat it once again. So actually, this is micro stepping, so I will discuss in details in the next class, and then we'll go for the stepper motor advantage, disadvantage, and its applications also, why it is being used. So with this, stepper motor has a very wide range of application in nowadays, and so it requires another say this session for discussing details of all these things. So today I think that's all.